I give my number out all the time when I'm also drunk. I actually, like, a lot of my fans have my numbers, but I love, like, texting with them.
Hi, Kim Petras.
What's up?
How's it going?
Great. I'm so excited to be here.
You're so excited. You are in the UK. You're at Manchester Pride. Like, this is going to go off this afternoon.
Yeah, it's going to slap.
Yeah. Have you got something, like, really exciting for, like, so many fans have just come out to see you.
Sick, yeah. I'm excited to meet my fans. This is my first time performing in Manchester, so this is really, really exciting. And my outfit is going to be sick, so.
Oh, yeah?
Yeah.
Any sneak peeks? What are we looking? Colors or?
Close, color-wise, close to this, but with a twist. Yeah, it's definitely sick. It's definitely bedazzled.
Bedazzled!
Yeah.
She's got the lingo. It's very Towie, isn't it? So I saw a tweet earlier as well from you with people going like, oh my God, you're on a massive billboard.
Yeah.
And you replying being like, last time I was here, there was 5 fans. And now, you know, you've got an entire crowd over there that are going to go.
Yeah, it's crazy. I mean, really, like a year ago when I came here, like nobody knew any of my songs. And this time around, it's a whole different story. I have like a sold out show in London. I have a huge billboard from Gay Times and Apple Music.
Yeah.
So yeah, I just like was walking down the street and was like, there's my big ass forehead.
What's that like then? Like a year later, just actually taking it all in and seeing.
It's amazing. I mean, it feels like 10 years because just like this last year was just like back to back. Like it was like Lady Gaga being like another club, another club, another club, plane, train, bus, another club. So it was like that's kind of the last year. So it's like kind of all a blur and my life has just like completely changed. And it's just like it's so exciting.
Has summer just been insane for you then?
Yeah, it's been so nuts. Yeah.
Have you performed? Yeah.
So much. Everything.
Have you been able to like actually have a holiday, anything like that, or?
No, I really don't want to now. Like, I feel like it's like go time for me. Like, I've been waiting my whole life to do this. Like, been a songwriter first, writing for other people, then kind of broke out like doing my own stuff and just like been like hustling and grinding away. And like now it's just like now it's just like starting to happen. Like I'm just like starting to see it like pay off, and like my fans are so amazing. Like I don't know what I did before them, and just like it's a whole like I don't know, I'm just like a completely different person.
I love that. I think your fans being able to change who you are as a person and an artist as well is such
they give me so much confidence to just like be myself, because before I was like my first songs were kind of more of a like persona a little bit, because I was like, who cares what I have to say, you know? Like it's just like, so I kind of made up like a bigger than life like character, like superhero character pretty much, and sang really bratty LA songs, and you know, just like was really inspired by that kind of a persona. And now I feel like I'm stripping it back and I'm just like, this is me, and I want my records to feel more like hanging out with me rather than like building up a character, you know?
So we are like halfway through the year. The summer is slightly coming to an end, but like what next? What are we doing for winter? We got it like locked in.
First of all, it doesn't feel like summer's coming to an end. It's so hot right now.
Feeling it.
I know.
I'm like roasting.
I know. Same. Like it's been so hot. The spooky season is upon us. So
are you a full on Halloweener?
I mean, I stan. I'm such a Halloweener. I mean, you bet. I dropped a Halloween EP last year.
Yeah.
It's called Turn Off the Light Volume 1, which implies it's going to be a Volume 2. So,
Are you telling me now that it's not an implication? It's going to happen?
No, I'm just saying it implies it.
You're not telling me anything, are you?
I may or may not have like finished most of the vocals before I left to London, but I won't tell you.
Okay. We'll talk after, it's fine, you know. Don't tell it in front of 10 cameras and anything like that. But so for Halloween then, are you just going to go all out? Like,
yeah.
You should host your own Halloween party.
All the way. I really want to throw a major Halloween party this year. Last year I was on tour with Troye Sivan in America, which is sick.
Yeah.
But I didn't get to dress up because I think we literally had a show on Halloween at the Greek Theater. And I just like, I covered myself in blood, like my tour outfit. But that was kind of it.
Just walking into like the toilet and seeing someone and be like, you're right.
Yeah.
Just covered in it.
Yeah, it was sick. People were just like really feeling it. They were like, yes, bloody queen.
She's here. Kim, I want to play a quick game of Never Have I Ever.
Let's go.
I've got a couple. You know, we've got this beautiful tinned canned water because Woo! Water comes in cans now.
The future is really here.
We are in
canned water.
Are you ready? So, never have I ever dumped someone by text.
No, I haven't.
You haven't?
No.
You've never had to?
Uh-uh. Oh. I know. I'm really lucky, but at the same time, like, I never want to do that. Like, I never want somebody out there who can say I dumped them by a text. Such a horrible thing.
I've dumped someone by song.
Oof.
Yeah.
I mean, sick.
Just send them a song and be like, that's a bit of you, and then bye.
Damn.
Yeah. I'm brutal. It's fine.
They'll hate that song.
Never have I ever embarrassed myself at a wedding.
No. I've been to, like, one wedding.
Same. Why, like, I really...
I don't know. I'm glad. Like, I feel like it would make me so pressured if I was going to weddings all the time and just, like, saw that happening. So... Yeah, I'm also kind of avoiding weddings, to be honest. I'm just like, yeah.
It's a bit too much. Like, I see all my mates getting married now, and I'm like, no.
Yeah, I know. Same.
You just want to party.
I know. I just want to party all the time.
Okay, never have I ever sexted a wrong number. You're thinking about it.
Nah.
No?
Like, I've done a lot to the wrong number of just, like, I've talked trash about somebody and then texted it to that person.
Oh,
and
no.
I know, I have like...
With their full-on receipts, like screenshots and everything.
Yeah, for sure. And I've been like, I have a crush on this person, and I was really drunk, and I sent it to that person I had a crush on. That was like when I was 16, so my world was like over. I got like blackout drunk right away. And
ground swallowed.
Then
up,
from
God.
Then on, never stop being blackout drunk all the time. I'm kidding.
Oh my God. All right, never have I ever lied to get out of doing something.
Oh, for sure.
All the time.
In school?
Yeah.
Every morning, I was trying to pull it off.
What was your
My parents, like, eventually, like... I mean, I was just like, I'm sick all the time.
Yeah.
Yeah, I really didn't like school.
What was your best, like, I haven't done my homework excuse?
Oh, my God. What was my best one? I'm, like, a horrible liar, to be honest. Except for to my parents. Like, I'm great at lying to my parents. But that's it.
Oh, my parents know like anything I say, I'm like, oh, God.
Yeah, I know. But, like, I know. Mom, I'm sorry. When I was a kid, now it's completely different. No, I feel like I don't get away with lying ever. Like, I'm just, like, starting to stutter and just, like, I'm just not born
You've
to
lie. You've got all the tells.
Not born to lie.
Awful. All right, last one. Never have I ever ghosted someone.
Yeah.
Duh.
For sure. Yeah. All the time.
You're too popular.
Yeah, I'm so popping. I have for sure ghosted people. But yeah, not my friends, you know.
No.
But like random people.
Smashed it.
It's okay. I give my number out all the time when I'm also
really?
Drunk. I've been talking about being really drunk.
Do you not
a
have
lot.
Like two separate numbers or anything?
No, I don't. No. I actually like a lot of my fans have my numbers, but I love like texting with them. But
Do they
number.
Ever, like, ring you, like, at 3 a.m., like, hey?
No. I feel like I'm really good at, like, picking them, and, like, they just, like, text me cute stuff and, like, say hi and how you doing, and I really feel like I'm like, friends with a bunch of my
that
friends.
That is, like, fully connected to your
yeah,
fans.
Yeah, it's cool. Like, they like, totally, like, respect, like, they're just, like, I don't know. They're, like, my legit friends.
They are the best.
They don't call it, like, 3 a.m. I know. You guys are the best.
Smashed it. Ken Petras, thank you so much.
Thank you so much. This was lit.
The biggest hits.
The biggest throwbacks.
Hits. Ready, boom.